It feels pretty damn satisfying to wear a comfortable old sweater, especially after you found out that you're actually a lot fatter than the last time you wear it. That's essentially what it feels like when I'm reading articles that just revive the memories of last year, where people are being pissed at sex robots and I'm just sitting here comfortably drinking my fine milk. Not wine, because I still couldn't legally drink one until the next year. So now we're getting into an article that talks about a classic topic. Tune in to classical music and get ready for a breeze, because we're in for something relaxing.
Maybe sex robots will make men, not women, obsolete. They might at least create some healthy competition.
Now, this is what happens when a feminist decided to use the logic that weebs have been using for the past few decades. Except those weebs are being ironic. And even if they aren't, instead of having these feminists being called misogynists, these feminists got tons and tons of praise. That is very empowering of you to call men obsolete thanks to sex robots. That is until you find out that you just spent your entire money on it and it can't even make a monthly salary. Unless you open up a brothel. And even then, good luck with that, when if we Joshis would rather see the Casa free jerking each other off.
Advances in robotics and artificial intelligence have raised a dystopian concern for women. What if female robots become so realistic and so adept at sex that they render men incapable of engaging in real human relationships? Actually, I think it's the men who should be worried. It's entirely possible that robots can outperform them.
Well, lady, let me break the news for you. Fapping with the help of an object designed for sexual pleasure that has practically zero agency is definitely going to outperform any man in the world, except in providing you basic needs like money, food, and house. But you're a feminist who has graduated in gender studies. I'm sure all of you can live by yourselves and don't need the help of those pesky men with sustainable income and infinitely better life than your miserable existence. Actually, a more interesting question that should be asked is whether or not you actually want to buy sex robots and whether or not you literally consider men obsolete thanks to their existence, which is a nicer way of saying, is this article just you taking a doo-doo? Well, this video is just gonna be me taking my own doo-doo, and another way for me to make this doo-doo fun is if I drink 10 times more milk.
Perhaps it's time for a big think. Are women not as capable as men of crude objectification? There's room here for everyone's impure thoughts and desires. Robots don't discriminate, and they can probably give good massages.
Lady, women are about as capable of objectification as men do. I don't know what they taught you in universities, but if they tell you that women are incapable of impure thoughts and desires, the nukes here only needs a good target.
Don't get me wrong, I have a good husband. I doubt I would trade in. But if I had a daughter, I might consider giving her a robot as a college graduation present, preferably one who can do the dishes and guard the door.
So a maid robot. Excellent, lady. I also want a maid robot. One can then preferably do my laundries, clean the dishes, make some food, etc. Unfortunately, as I've discussed in my videos in the past, the uncanny valley nature of some of these humanoid robots can turn off every guy at sex. So at this moment, even if my robot looks like Aegis, I prefer for Aegis to just do basic chores. I still prefer the privacy of looking at porn from my good old Android phone, which honestly, if it were a person, it would be in a straitjacket in a mental hospital due to the trauma of being sexually abused by me. Oh, don't you start judging me about my search history. At least it's still alive. I bet your PCs would spontaneously combust the moment it starts typing your favorite sex fetish, like Pantyless Count Dankula.
And yes, I do think women could get spoiled by dashing men bots. Their standards might go up. They might even be lost to the dating pool altogether, like what's already happened with some Japanese men.
The difference is that if women do it, it's perfectly fine. It's progressive and you're a really damn cool person. You guys aren't even considered into the dating pool, and women will now have higher standards to men, as if their standards aren't high enough already. If men do it, that's objectification, misogyny, and you are an absolute weeb loser who lives in your parents' basement fantasizing on things that you will never ever get. Equality, ladies and gentlemen.
Would that be such a bad thing? In the hashtag MeToo age, I feel like raising standards is quite reasonable. It's called for, in fact. Make the men compete. It's the dating equivalent of having free state colleges lower tuition rates everywhere.
Oh, lady, if there's one thing that men absolutely love is competition. You're asking us to compete against the sex bots? Challenge accepted. See how long you're gonna keep on saying men are obsolete as you squeeze out every last penny that you have for that thing when you realize that it can't even find work with a decent sustainable income. At least dildos are cheap and porn is free. Come to think of it, lady, as much as men yearn so much for competition, I don't think they'd be competing to get your attention. They'd be competing on who can program the first real waifu and just straight up exterminate any 3D women they come across. We would name this FOT extermination program gender equality.
Granted, there could be dangers. There is, for example, the possibility that hackers could turn sex robots into killers, but the statistician in me can't help asking, would that make them more of a threat than actual men? Given the baseline murder rate for human sexual partners, it's hard to get too worried. Plus, if they can understand female anatomy, I mean, really understand it, maybe it's worth the risk.
Damn, lady, I'm starting to question whether or not you're a weeb in disguise and that this article is a satire. Sex bots can be hacked into killer robots? Doesn't matter had sex.
Just to be clear, I'm not saying we should want to live in a militant feminist world without men. Far from it. I am suggesting that women and men can coexist, but possibly not cohabitate. Men will likely have trouble with things like household chores and remembering to go to the doctor regularly, but they will manage. Maybe Siri can make their appointments.
Men will likely have trouble with things like household chores and remembering to go to the doctor regularly. Lady, that's horrendously stereotypical of you. Just because I'm lazy at doing my chores doesn't mean that I cannot do it. I will tell someone else to do it in an instant because I am more bothered looking at two girls making out.
Who knows? If our sexual needs can be met by intimate, automated helpers, maybe we'll end up stronger as a community. We'll come together, online or in person, and be more respectful, more relaxed, less edgy. It's worth a try, so bring on the sex robots!
Perhaps. I yearn a time where both genders can exist in peace without both of them just starting to fling fire at each other. Now, if you ask me, the sort of person who threatened the existence of that utopian world is named a feminist. At least the weebs are there just jerking off to their 2D waifus and every semblance of 3D women will be actively avoided or pushed down the toilet. These feminists are actually doing real damage to society and they're going to make sure that every men's rights activist and even men's rights are being trampled down thanks to the lack of money to buy some more dye to color their ugly purple hairs. No offense, Aiden. Unfortunately, that's the end of the article. Like every comfortable sweater, it had to be laundried, and like every hot chocolate, it will eventually run out, and the session has to end, and I have to go back to work and do some real job. Like grabbing another set of comfortable sweater and another set of hot chocolate, so let's talk about something else. VRChat has been incredibly popular as of late, even when they're still in early access. Unfortunately, the requirement of this game is a VR headset, which, while I can definitely buy one without any problems, but another requirement would be a computer with a GTX 970 or a 1060 or stronger. Looks like I'm gonna have to pile up some more money, which you can definitely help me to join the virtual world by donating to my Patreon or PayPal. Brag, brag. Speaking of which, thank you Jamil for the pledge and Greg for the donation. You guys are fantastic. Actually, you don't have to donate because weirdly, despite being called VR chat, you can actually play the game without any sorts of VR peripherals. That's pretty weird. That's like being able to play a game called Gun without a gun con- Oh wait. One of the avatars that become a phenomenon in VR chat is this weird aberration called Uganda Knuckles. The design basically came from a Sonic review by Greg Zilla. The usage of this design then become a weird phenomenon in VR chat alongside virtual reality lolly cockfights. There's an interesting article in Know Your Meme that just tells you the story behind the scenes. If you want to see it, link down below. And there's also another article, but this time by Polygon, in which the meme is called Problematic. Yes, 2018 is a time where a meme database site is a lot more fair and balanced than actual game news website. I'm really getting sick of the word problematic because it's about as vague as reading YouTube's community guidelines in a burned sheet of paper. What does problematic even mean? If I use the word problematic, it usually means that it can potentially cause problems. And if that's the case, then a problem without failure is always going to be outraged journalists and a bunch of moral guardians on Twitter. So yes, I guess the meme can be considered problematic, except in my perspective, outraged moral guardians isn't a problem. It means more and more fun videos to make. Now the meme basically came into Storm thanks to a video of Uganda Knuckles saying "Do you know the way?" which is actually a meme associated with the aforementioned country and also a reference to one of the most underappreciated movies of our time, Who Killed Captain Alex. Absolutely fantastic movie, 10 out of 10. Check it out. And since the meme is associated with basically mocking the African accent, a lot of people have come in storm basically virtue signaling over how incredibly racist the meme was. Why is it not okay to mock the African accent when the Brits, the Europeans, the Australians, and the Southerns basically got it all the freaking time? It's almost like there's a bias towards white people or something. I don't know. So let's check out some of these brilliant commentators.
Uganda Knuckles, forced, unfunny, racist. Ha ha, African voice isn't funny. Cat marching band, pretty underrated, brings joy, cute. Not racist, not forced.
Ah, yes, something so safe and so painfully bland and boring as a freaking cat marching band is going to be 2018's most definitive memes. Do you want to see something hilarious? The guy who made Who Killed Captain Alex essentially retweeted the memes constantly. That's right, he didn't mind having his accent mocked the same way I don't mind if you mock mine. At least after a concentrated barrage of bullets. But hey, being offended on the internet means you can literally wish on anything. So every single time someone says traps are not gay, I will slam their face right up to Astolfo's magnificent testicles. Another interesting thing about these virtue signaling jackasses is we also have a freaking LARPer.
Look, I am Uganda, and I'm telling you the meme is racist. Simply put, what's so funny about it in the first place? Do you find our accent silly? We aren't here to be laughed at, and have the belief that we are somehow lesser than Westerners by having said Westerners mock us.
Ah, yes. If people mock the Cockney accent, that automatically means they think the Brits are lesser than them. Not only that, this is an extreme logical leap, but the Cockney accent is also silly, and they're acceptable to mock. So why the outrage over African accent, who is also pretty silly? Because they're blacks, of course, and blacks need their feelings to be protected, despite the fact that they constantly have supplies of AK-47. Again, keep in mind that the creator of Who Killed Captain Alex constantly retweeted this meme left and right, and it turns out that our intellectual of today is LARPing as a Ugandan, who for some reason cannot speak the native African language? Maybe an immigrant, but I'm very sure most immigrants can speak their native language just fine. Or how about this intellectual gem?
Ugandan Knuckles is a racist crap-ass meme. People are running around VRChat as a deformed Knuckles with a very crappy racist Ugandan accent. Do you know the way? Which of course spills out everywhere else because gamers need to be put up against the wall and shot.
And virtue signalers like you need to be sliced in half with a chainsaw and thrown into a volcano. I can do this game too, except I can be more creative with the deaths. We can keep throwing insults or actually discuss why it's racist, and if it ends up with you making ridiculous logic leaps with complete misinterpretation of the situation, even if the context is obvious, opinion discarded. Throw yourself in a volcano.
Uganda Knuckles is racist. VR Chat's rise to fame will forever be defined by some idiots clicking their tongues and mocking an African nation. Screw you if you retweet that crap on my timeline.
Ah, yes, we are definitely mocking Uganda, not referencing a classic masterpiece. Again, Who Killed Captain Alex is a timeless classic, and I want you to strap yourself and watch that movie right now.
Can I stop seeing that freaking Knuckles Uganda meme thing? It's racist and ugly and unfunny, and I don't want to see it. I wish people would realize.
Well, a little bit of PSA, and I'm afraid I have to tell this to every single one of you noobs on the internet. Telling people to not do something will make them do it more. And if you tell people to stop tweeting Uganda Knuckles, you're going to be spawned with tons and tons and tons of them, especially on your replies. So don't bother checking it unless you want to add more people in your block list, which is going to be pretty much everyone.
If you see tweets about how racist the Uganda Knuckles joke is but ignore them, congrats for your complicity in racism 2018.
That's right, retweeting about Uganda Knuckles mean that I am contributing into the hatred of blacks, Asian, and other minorities in real life. All of this despite the fact that, once again, the original filmmaker retweeted this meme constantly. So if it's not racist to the original creator, then who is it racist to? Easily offended moral guardians who think anything and everything is sexist and racist, including your dog?
But it's funny! Stereotyping an entire people as ignorant and mindless is not funny. It's racist and ugly and cruel. So don't be a part of the problem.
Of course, you shouldn't stereotype black people as ignorant and mindless. That is just racist, ugly, and cruel. You can do that to white people though, that's perfectly acceptable.
I'ma be completely honest and say non-black people need to pay close attention to what they find humorous because I'm seriously confused on how so many of my mutuals don't find the Uganda Knuckles thing racist.
You are confused in why you don't find the Uganda Knuckles meme racist. Well, maybe because you're just an overly sensitive Tumblrite who is going to be offended at anything and everything. You know, I can just pay attention to what you personally think is not humorous and then revel at how not funny you are, or I can just tweet out more Knuckles meme and make my life happier. Did you know that being miserable and depressed can make you end up in a Logan Paul video? 2018 already started off with some absolutely crazy stuff. I wonder what more craziness that we're going to witness in the future. I hope that's also the time where Uganda Knuckles sex bots are on sale.